Grayson now knew why the Cloven were in the catacombs, to gain access to the hundreds of thousands of human bodies that were being stored there. Later, we would wonder if it was just an easy food source, or if there wasn't some reason, some ritual, born of the Cloven's hive mind, that would be forever inexplicable to us. All Grayson knew was that Bouchard, followed by Mallory, had left the abandoned processing complex beneath the city and was heading towards the Chimera Tower that she called the Chrysalis Lair. It would take everything he had to find her.
Thank you. my God. Rain, did you see this? All these bodies. Thousands of them. Women. Sisters. Daughters. All I wanted to do was avenge my brother. But I was being selfish. I see that now.
Then you've changed your mind? Or do you still intend to murder them all?
Hell yes. I'm gonna wipe the Chimera from the face of the Earth.
Get the flank on their left. Do something to draw fire off the infantry. Come on! Don't stop! Double time!
Stack up, men! Soldiers on me!
Right behind you, sir. Parker, we can't maintain this diversion forever. Grayson had better make it through to Paris.
Thank you.
approaching the lair. Going silent now, James. Leaving my radio behind. I don't need the distraction or temptation to turn back.
You're hesitant for a reason. Trust your instincts. I can help you deliver the serum.
Goodbye, James.
Rain, no, don't! Oh, shit. Mallory, if you're close, try and stop her. Come on, Mallory! Stay with me, Bouchard. I'm on my way.
Paris had been transformed beyond recognition. From his vantage point inside the Chimera machine, Grayson could see only a maze of structures, a confusing web of iron and glass. The Eiffel Tower, once the crown jewel of the Parisian skyline, was now a mere pillar of what would become a vast Chimeran city. A city unlike anything ever seen by mankind. And unless Grayson succeeded, one that no man would live to see. While he knew that Bouchard must already be somewhere inside, he was driven by something he could never explain, to find her.
Grayson, come in. Are you there?
Parker, Grayson here.
Grayson, thank God. Where are you? Have you found Bouchard?
Long story. Bouchard's gone radio silent. We can't count on her. But I've got the vial you gave me. I see the chrysalis lair now. I'm gonna shove the serum right up their ass. Thank God this thing has heating.
They call this thing a hammer. I just pounded that ape into the ground. Uh-oh. I should have known. It never gets easy.
Hang up, eh? Bunch of twits.
cry for help.
Running low on you guys by now. Fuck me.
Thank you.
Marquis forces and Cartwright's British commandos were successful in pushing through the Chimera outer defenses. Now they were in a desperate battle for the main Chimera tower. Cartwright's assault had accomplished its objective by diverting Chimeran forces away to the south, reducing the number Grayson had to face as he fought his way through the outer structures of the Chrysalis Lair. Even with Chimera forces diverted southwards by Cartwright's assault, it would be impossible to reach the tower over land. But Grayson had driven the Chimera machine as far as he could, up to the brink of the frozen Seine. To reach the lair itself, Grayson would have to get past its outer fortifications. The only way to get past the outer walls was to go under them. Later, Grayson could not say why he left his brother's jacket behind. It seemed almost symbolic, a ritual not unlike that of the Cloven, as if Grayson wanted to leave behind the part of his past that had destroyed him, that being submerged beneath the frozen Seine might somehow become a ritual cleansing. Regardless, there can be no doubt that the James Grayson who entered the Seine was not the same man we had sentenced to death only weeks before.
Cartwright, Grayson here. Your diversionary attack's working. I've reached the Seine.
You have to hurry, Grayson. I'm not sure how much longer we can sustain our assault.
I should reach the lair within an hour. All depends on how many damn gorillas they've got left.
Thank you.
Parker, tell the McKee they can stop trying to contact Bouchard. I've found her.
Grayson, are you there? Come in, Grayson!
Or should I say, I've found what's left of her. What the... Mallory! I didn't kill her!
You gave her hope the conversion centers could be explored. Research conducted. You drove her to this tummy. You are responsible.
Mallory, she used you. From the beginning, you're infected. You're becoming one of them. She lied to you, Roland, just like she lied to me.
No, Tommy. I chose this to be more than human. Go ahead, shoot me. You can't hurt me now.
We'll see about that. I've killed hundreds of Chimera, Molly. Thousands, including my own brother. I've never enjoyed it until now.
We're out of time! Get back! Get back!
Carl Wright. I've achieved the objective. Say again, I'm at ground zero. Get your men out of there.
Roger that. Fall back. Get those men out of there.
Cartwright, good job. I'd have never made it this far if these gorillas hadn't been distracted.
Good luck, Grayson. We'll see you on the other side.
Somehow I doubt it. So far, nothing that's gone in has ever come out.
Cartwright out. Go, move out.
Little was known about the new Chimera conversion process outside of Dr. Claude Bouchard's research. We knew that until recently, no female Chimera had ever been seen. Human females, it seemed, had been stored in the catacombs' DNA facility for use in later phases of the Chimera invasion. Bouchard wrote that inside the Chrysalis lair was a structure she called Le Cœur de la Mère, the Mother Chamber. It was here that the Chimera DNA was implanted into human subjects before they were taken to facilities like the one in Bonn. To deploy the serum and infect the carriers, Grayson would have to enter this heart, the womb where the Chimera hags were conceived in the bodies of human females. Colonel Roland Mallory disappeared in Paris. and has to this day never been seen again. Later, Marquis Command questioned Grayson, but Grayson had nothing to say and the case was never remanded to military authority. Once, I had also asked Grayson what transpired inside the Chrysalis Lair, and all he would ever say was that everything changed.
Parker, I'm inside the lair. It's like no conversion complex I've ever seen.
Grayson, I can't read you. Come in. Grayson!
Oh, I don't even want to know what this shit is.
I'm nearing the upper levels of the lair. Carriers moving in and out, like blood vessels carrying oxygen. This is what Rain discovered. It's like a bloody Chimera assembly line. The carriers retrieve the bodies from storage, like the chamber beneath Paris, and bring them here, where the transformation process begins. And where it's going to end.
Whoa!
That's it! Turn!
Come on.
Never doing that again.
Fucking hell!
Located the wound. I'm going to inject the serum.
Whoa! What just...
Parker, I was trapped underwater. I should have drowned, but I can breathe it really.
To deploy the serum and infect the carriers, Grayson would have to enter this heart, the womb where the Chimera hags were conceived in the bodies of human females.
Shot. Rain, what's happened to you?
Christmas. I knew you would come.
No! What have they done?
You promised to help me, James.
Get out of my head!
You think you can resist, but you are mistaken. Join us.
The way my brother joined you? It's too late, Rain. The serum's already spreading. Like a virus. The entire system's collapsing. How many carriers have already left infected, Rain? How long before this is all gone?
James, headache?
Oh, stupid broads and your mind games. I had to kill you, Rain. You know that.
helped me. I am on your side.
I should have killed you when I had the chance. Killed you when I had the chance.
You can't kill us. Yes, you ran into your resources. There are wounds in us. Infinite number. We will not stop.
You're wrong, Rain. Or whatever the hell you are. The serum is working. Your father's virus is spreading. Soon, every carrier in the world will be dead.
James! We're not dead. The serum spread. Set off triggers. They're so advanced.
Rain, what are you saying?
Carriers gone. Just triggered new types. Spinners. James, no matter what we do, they just keep evolving.
Rain! Goodbye, Ray.
Cartwright's task force was successful, just as in London. When the Paris Tower fell, Chimera forces everywhere in Western Europe became disorganized, confused, and began to die. Grayson was also successful. At least it seemed so at first. Dr. Bouchard's serum worked as designed. Carriers spread the contaminated fluid from the mother chamber to facilities all over France and Germany. The new conversion process ground to a halt. But while Western Europe had earned a short reprieve, reports continued to come in from Russia, the Balkans, and Spain. Chimera forces were on the move. Vast fleets of Chimera dropships were being constructed, their targets and destinations unknown. Grayson never talked about what happened inside the Chrysalis lair to anyone, but it was obvious to everyone that Grayson was changed in ways we would never understand. Did you ever find any sign of her? Bouchard, I mean.
Yeah. I found her. She was already dead.
I don't know what happened in there, James, but don't let her death destroy you the way you let your brother's. It's time to bury our dead.
I don't need a lecture, Parker. I'll be fine.
Wait. I've got something for you. British Command has cleared your record. We're offering you a field commission. How does Major Grayson sound?
Well, I sit on my arse all day like Cartwright. Hey, speak of the devil.
Grayson, I've been looking for you. I think this is yours. Some of the boys found it during mop-up. I thought you'd want it.
It belongs here. As someone said, it's time to bury our dead.
Keep it, James. Your brother would want you to.
Maybe he would have at that.
Goodbye, Colonel. Major.
Goodbye, James.
Hey, I hear the McKee have a replacement opening for a colonel. Maybe I'll apply.
Goodbye, James.
Shall we? There's still a war going on, last I checked.
We never saw Grayson again. He did join the Marquis, volunteering to lead a dangerous mission into the heart of Russia to find the source of the Chimera invasion. During the Battle of Warsaw, 12th of June 1953, the Marquis listed Grayson as missing in action. But I had to wonder. Among the Russian refugees, there were rumors of a British soldier seen roaming the streets of Minsk, Kiev, and Moscow. A man they called the Cloven Killer. Perhaps Grayson did die in Warsaw. But I like to think that somewhere out there, James Grayson had found another cause worth living for.